Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I am working with this awesome digital kit from Kellybell Designs. It is called Checking Into Aulani, and I am also utilizing a sketch that I had created for 30 days of sketches with Christy's Beautiful Life. And today I am showing you how to stretch a sketch. As you can tell, if you look at my channel, I do a lot of double page layouts, and I like to use a lot of pictures, and I have a ton of photos that I had taken last year when we were at the Disney's Aulani Resort in Hawaii. And I just had too many photos to just do one page, so I am stretching that out. So I'm just using the photos that I have, just the regular 4x6 photos, and I'm cutting some of them down to 3x4, and I'm doing kind of a mirror image. So I have a few of them that I just really liked, and they're of the outside of Aulani, and so I'm going to go ahead and line them up, and then I'm going to add in my embellishment clusters. Now, all of the embellishment clusters, or all of the embellishments that I have, are from the Checking Into Aulani kit from Kellybell Designs, as well as the paper. And let me just tell you, having the ability to have custom paper, especially for something like this, is just really wonderful. A lot of times, I think we get limited by the amount of scrapbook paper that there is, and sometimes I just really want a custom paper, and I just love that I have that ability. I do have a large format printer, however, it's not required. If you just have a regular printer that's 8.5 by 11, you can always print that out an 8.5 by 11 and it and just use it to work for you. Right? It's just wonderful. And I even keep my scraps because I love them so much. Now you'll see on the right side, I have a portrait and orientation photo. And on the left side, I have a landscape orientation. So that is going to add just a little bit of interest to my page. And now I'm going to be working with some of those print and cut elements. You can, if you have a Cricut or any kind of die cut machine, you can upload them to your cutting software and it will cut it out for you. The one nice thing about that, you can resize it like I did here with this ribbon. Or if you don't have that, you can certainly fussy cut it out as well. And I have done that as well. And so I'm just going to go ahead and continue with my photo clusters. I have these really cool palm trees. There were so many really cool trees and greenery while we were there. And it was just nice to be able to have it. Now you'll see I was going to tuck it underneath this ribbon element. And I glued down the ribbon element too soon. So that's okay. We're just going to work with it. We're going to make it happen. I really just wanted to have two major cluster areas there. And one's going to be at the top and one's more towards the bottom right. And the purpose of this is to draw your eye across the page. So if you're looking for like some specific design elements, you want to do things that are going to draw your eye to the places that you are wanting people to look at. And so since I have things that span two pages, I really want to draw it across the page. Another thing that I'm going to be doing in my clusters is I'm going to put some similar elements on the left as well as the right. And I'm also doing that with my photos. You'll see my photos are lined up in the middle on both sides. And that's going to draw your eye across that page as well. Now sometimes, as you'll see here, I'm using a different background paper on the left and the right. They have similar colors, But don't feel like you have to use the same background paper on both sides of your layout. You can definitely coordinate pages. You can pull elements from the left and the right. One of the reasons this works so well is because, number one, it's the same, there's some similar colors in the left side and the right side. And also, if you are able to look closely, the Aulani symbol is on the left and the right. And so you can definitely get a little bit of that tie-in as well. So I had used the alphabet for my title and just uploaded each individual letter so I could spell out Aulani. And I am just using some dimensional tape to pop this up just a little bit. And let me tell you, this is like having your own thickers. So I can add a little bit of dimension there, and it looks like I have some thickers, which is kind of nice. It's a really nice, you know, I like one of the things that I like to mention on my channel, of course, is how to save a little bit of money. And that is certainly a way to save money, because you have unlimited use of the letters and you don't have to waste anything, because you can just print the letters that you like. So there is a little hack for you. So now on this left side, I'm going to also add in these little trees like I had on the left side, and I'm going to use the Aulani arch, I guess that's what I call it anyway. That is going to be the cluster that's going to come down on this side of the page. So I will, of course, link you to this kit on the Kellybell site. You can get the bundle, or you can download some of the individual elements, such as the cut aparts, I think, and there's just so many cool things on there. So I'll make sure to link you. As well, I will, if you're not part of the Kellybell fan group, I will definitely leave a link down there as well for that. And for everyone who is playing along with the 30 days of sketches, like I said, this is a sketch that I had designed for that event. So I hope that you will check that out as well. And if you use this sketch, you know, let me know, tag me on social media, or leave a comment in down below. I would love to see what you do with this sketch. Are you going to stretch it out? Are you going to use just the one side? If you use this kit, let me know. I love to see if something that I have done has inspired you. That's always exciting to see. So there are both pages put together with my embellishments, and I'm going to add in my journaling once I have finished up. So there are all the cutouts and the final layout. Once again, thank you so much for stopping by my channel. Your support of my channel means so much to me. Make sure you check out those links of all the other wonderful scrapbookers that are playing along with this sketch, and check out Kellybell Designs as well. Thanks, everyone. That's going to be it for me. I hope you have a magical day, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.